Well, the first phase of jury selection is complete in the trial of Officer Jeronimo Yanez. Monday, the pool would be reduced down to the 15 people who will ultimately hear the case. Lou Ragus joins us live with more on the makeup of the jury. Lou?
Yeah, Julie, there's not a lot of diversity when it comes to race in this jury pool. They're nearly all white, but they do come from different backgrounds. Today, there was an auto detailer in his 30s. An Army or Air Force combat medic, a retired truck driver, a couple people with teaching experience, even a man in his 20s who works at a box factory. Now, of the 23 jurors passed on to final consideration, half of them have little or no prior knowledge of this case. And of those who have heard a moderate amount, it was pretty interesting to hear their thoughts on it. For example, one approved juror said he was aware of Philando Castile's driving record and said, quote, "I think there's honestly a problem there with how minor things grow and become warrants. And then when you live where you can hardly afford fines, it seems like it's rigged against you." Now here's a look at the makeup of the jury pool. It includes 15 white men, 6 white women, 1 black man, and 1 black woman. There was one juror who was approved today despite a challenge from the prosecution. He's a member of the NRA, and he said something along the lines of that he believed Philando Castile was doing something wrong when he told Officer Yanez that he had a gun on him. But over the weekend, each side will think about which jurors they want to eliminate, and on Monday afternoon before opening statements begin, the prosecution will strike 3 and the defense will strike 5 jurors so that it will be 12 jurors and 3 alternates who will hear this case. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Lou.